I need to talk about the 3DS. The Nintendo 3DS was, in my opinion, Nintendo's best handheld. Because, come on, you call this thing a handheld? This console's just a wonderful, charming little device, and everything about it, to the design, to the library, and what's achievable on it, with a little bit of software exploitation, it's without a doubt that it's a good system. However, I just bought this one last week, after, well, two other attempts. I originally had and grew up playing on an original 2DS, which I got for my 10th birthday, and man, I had a lot of fun with it. I got introduced to the Zelda franchise by deciding to buy Ocarina of Time 3D for 20 bucks, which was one of the best decisions I've ever made in my life. I spent well over 100 hours playing Mario Kart 7. I spent too much time on YouTube, like, jeez. I met a ton of people through Street Pass, but most importantly, I played every single 2D Metroid on it right after meeting and falling in love with Dread. I loved playing on my 2DS and had a great time with it, but man, this thing's ugly. It served me well, but putting this thing in my pocket just doesn't work, even though that's exactly what I did for 6.5 years. But also, this has been happening for some reason, probably due to the SD card having an aneurysm. But a year ago, I would just say, skill issue, and suck it up, and work around it. But I'm employed. I have money. I can spend money. So after doing extremely complex, convoluted scientific research, also known as browsing YouTube search results for an hour, I decided that I was going to buy a Japanese new 3DS from eBay for $160. I was originally going to get the regular size new 3DS, but it got damaged and lost in shipping, so I refunded it and ended up getting the XL variant out of pure impatience. And I'm really glad everything happened the way that it did, because the screen size is really nice, and even the larger XL feels a bit small in my massive hands, so the regular model definitely would have been too small for me. But you might be wondering, why did I specifically want a new 3DS? You know, the one that's significantly more expensive than the older models. Two reasons. Nipple. And Isaac. If I was going to upgrade my 2DS to a 3DS, I thought I might as well just get the best possible rendition, being the new 3DS. I mean, you can run these games, only one mattering. It has three additional buttons, a tiny secondary analog stick, and two additional shoulder buttons. But I didn't care about any of these features, though. I wanted a new model because of two reasons. No, not the reason one being that the new models are very modular, meaning that after years of use and wear, if something becomes faulty or broken, I can just replace a specific part instead of upgrading the entire system again and losing all my data. Meaning that it'll last me possibly for forever, which is exactly what I want. And reason number two being that the new models are compatible with boot NTR, meaning that I can capture 3DS gameplay on the computer without dumping over $200 on a discontinued service I can't even pay for. Meaning if I ever want to stream modded Mario Kart 7 online, I can do that. Yeah, the new models also have face tracking 3D, aka 3D that's actually, you know, good. I couldn't care less about the feature, but upon using it, I have it on for every single game I play now, if it has it included. Also, the nipple? I can play Resident Evil Revelations with free camera control instead of tank controls with over-the-shoulder gyro aiming and mind-blowingly good 3D. Literally peak 3DS gaming right here. Not joking in the slightest, this is incredible. However, there was an issue with getting a Japanese model, which is its region locked. You can't play any American cartridges, you can't use the eShop, you can't sign into an American network ID, and you can't read anything. In order to bypass this huge hurdle, you have to hack it, which wasn't a problem for me in the slightest because I already hacked my 2DS, and I knew that I was going to be able to do it a second time. The only downside to buying a hacking a Japanese 3DS is the fact that the eShop is completely broken after region switching. But that shouldn't be a problem, right? I mean, the eShop's already shut down, like, what are you gonna lose? It shouldn't be a problem. Wrong! Very wrong! You see, the updates are downloaded from the eShop, so if you have to update a game, it'll be stuck on version 1 without any added content or patches, since you can't install the other updates. Thankfully, this can be worked around by simply downloading the patches from the H-Shop, which worked perfectly. I thought that was the only problem, but there was another one, and that was a bigger deal to me. Like I said before, I have spent almost 7 years playing my 2DS, and there's an application called the Activity Log that records your hours and times you've launched games. And I personally really like looking back at that history, but since the eShop is broken after region changing, it doesn't let me system transfer, meaning my Nintendo Network ID, Street Pass, and Activity Log are all stuck on my 2DS. Thankfully, I exclusively bought physical games instead of digital, so all my save files are completely safe and preserved, and I only really had bought Terraria for 5 bucks on my Nintendo Network ID and nothing else. So all I really lost by upgrading was my activity log, which sucks, but Maybe there's a way to transfer it, but I did do a ton of research and I only found one person do it successfully. And I tried to follow it, but it just corrupted my new 3DS, forcing me to do a quick factory reset. But the sacrifice of upgrading, even though I'm losing all these great memories, it really is worth it in my eyes. The benefits are just undeniably great, and modding it didn't just make the system functional, it made it the ultimate Nintendo all-in-one. Allowing me to play NES, SNES, Game Boy through Advance, N64, and PlayStation 1 games. Meaning that owning a Wii, a Switch, and a 3DS, I can play every single Nintendo game ever made. And not only that, but the 3DS is, of course, a tiny portable handheld. There's also some really cool homebrew applications you can download. There's a theme manager you can customize your home screen with. Checkpoint, which is a save file manager, allowing you to transfer digital game save data to a cartridge, which saved my life. There's emulators like SNES 9X and RetroArch, allowing you to, well, emulate SNES and PlayStation 1. H-Shop, a eShop replacement. And there's also some pretty neat stuff like ThirdTube, a YouTube client that does a decent job. Certimus, or something like that, which is an MP3 player allowing you to use your 3DS like an old iPod. Zash 3DS, a port of Half-Life, which runs good, but is a little janky when it comes to the menus. And the big one, the big boy, CTGP7, or Custom Track Grand Prix 7. A humongous Mario Kart 7 mod with even better multiplayer than the base game that competes with 8 Deluxe as being the best Mario Kart. If you hacked your 3DS already, absolutely check this one out. Now the games on the 3DS are worth talking about, because you don't just buy a game console to stare at it for hours. It's meant to be played. And as you saw earlier, I have quite a few. Now I'm not going to go all over all of these, but I'll briefly touch on the standouts. Kid Icarus Uprising, oh my gosh, quite possibly the best game on the 3DS ever. I'm still playing through it, so I can't really say much on it, but it's ridiculously good, and if you have a 3DS, it's a must-own, even if that means committing piracy, since your only options is that, or spending $100 on a $40 game. Link Between Worlds is the best 2D Zelda, not that there's a ton of competition, but that's still a pretty big accomplishment regardless. Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask are masterpieces, and you should be ashamed of yourself if you haven't played at least one of them. Resident Evil Revelations, in terms of gameplay and graphics, is really good in terms of gameplay and graphics. Look at this. This is running on the 3DS. The 3DS couldn't even run Isaac! Mario Kart DS and 7 are both very good, DS being the better single-player experience, and 7 being the better multiplayer experience, especially if you have CTGP. Both Kirby games are really good, but Planet Robot's really, really good. Metroid Samus Returns is a fantastic game that I didn't like at all. 3D Land is a good game for a 3DS game. I mean, come on. Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, okay, hold on, just slow down for a second, alright? This game, I like it. I think it's great. Well, not great, I think it's good. Yeah, the mission break structure is dumb, but Scarescraper is, like, super good. But I like it more than Luigi's Mansion 3 because of the slam mechanic in that game that halts the pacing and pauses combat constantly, when the whole gimmick of Dark Moon is to continuously suck without having to pause and... Look, okay, dodging incoming attacks and swerving to continuously drain the enemy's health bar, it's extremely engaging, and the gameplay is, in my opinion, the best of the trilogy, even if the level design is possibly the worst. Donkey Kong's great, even if Tropical Freeze ruined it for me. Shovel Knight's good, even if I wasn't crazy on it. Smash is Smash, and Terraria is the best two-dimensional game ever made. And Mario Party DS is superior to every single Mario Party game released on the 3DS, and it's not even that good, which is that depressing. I mean, the 3DS library really just is great. Not only are you able to play all these great 3DS and DS games, but you can emulate every generation of Nintendo games prior to the GameCube on it. Which might not sound like a lot, or all that impressive, considering that you can do the exact same thing on a computer and emulate GameCube and Wii and Switch on that as well, but this is official Nintendo hardware, and its beautiful clamshell design that protects the screen and shrinks its own size down makes it a wonderful handheld gaming device. It just slides in your pocket, you can just pull it out, open it, hear that click, and just boot up whatever game you want. And in my eyes, it's, again, the ultimate Nintendo all-in-one.